Hi everyone, welcome to the Human Experiment. I'm Anandi, spiritual teacher and author. And what I am looking at is exploring, reconciling our divinity through the human experience and vice versa. So I call it an experiment because I have no idea what's going to happen or what to expect. And that's really the fun in it for me. So the question that came up to talk about today is kind of a fun one for me, and hopefully you'll find so too. And that is, what is the deal with spiritual names? Now, everyone has, I suppose, their own reason for taking a spiritual name or changing their name, and I'm no different. So what I wanted to share with you was a little bit about my name, how I got it, and what happened. So as I said, my name is Anandi. That's my spiritual name. And it means bliss-filled. Now, I wasn't really big into spiritual names. It wasn't a really important thing to me. But suddenly, it became important. And that was after I had gotten pretty serious with my commitment to my spiritual practice. And I had become initiated into a lineage. And other people around me started taking spiritual names. So I was very curious about the whole process and the ceremony of it. And secretly and silently, I was sort of pining away, waiting for this special occasion where in my mind I thought I would be told that it was time for me to take a spiritual name. That it was somehow significant to this stage of my own development progress. And at least certainly that's kind of what the story was in my head. So on top of that, I also had a particular name in mind that I was hoping for. And it wasn't really anything specific other than I really longed to be named after Anandamayi Ma. If you don't know who she is, look her up. So finally, after being really impatient, I petitioned my teacher and I said, you know, so I'm kind of ready for a spiritual name. And she says, oh, I wondered when you were going to ask. So immediately I had this experience where what I was thinking and what I expected to happen got completely turned on its head. I very cautiously, because I didn't know if there was an injuncture, went to my teacher to ask about it, and she had been waiting for me to ask. So that happened. And then, much to my disappointment, she gave me a list of names and told me to pick. So I was totally deflated because in my mind, I thought, again, this was something that was going to be bestowed upon me, that was symbolic of something. And here my teacher was giving me a list of names to choose from. And my understanding had been, much like a parent names a child, a teacher, a guru, will give their disciple or student a name. And that's what I expected. And she actually said, I don't usually do this, but I'm going to pick a name. So I went through the names, and Anandi was on the list, but I didn't choose it. I went down through the list, and I ended up choosing another name, which was Atma Jyoti. And it sounded beautiful, and it sounded very, you know, committed and serious. And I had a ton of phenomenon around it. You know, there was energetic phenomenon, stuff going on in my body. So I thought, yes, this must be the name. And I tell her, and she says, okay, that's your name. So it took about a year for me to really grow to hate that name and to have phenomenon when she addressed me with that name. I couldn't say it right. Other people couldn't say it. It just never felt right. So eventually, again, I go to her and I, very embarrassed, say, I hate my name. I just hate it. And she was relieved and said, oh, I wondered how long it was going to take you. That was not the name I would have chosen for you. Very well, pick another name. And I said, oh, no, 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 no. You choose my name. You choose my name. I did not want to screw up again. And she said, okay, Anandi. It's always been Anandi. Now, if you haven't picked up on it, there is a little bit of magic in that story. Anandi had been on the list, and I totally looked over it. And there's so many themes woven into that story about my, you know, what I thought was supposed to happen, and about being committed but not feeling valid myself. So there was this unfolding of experience just through the process of the name. But then what began to happen was I recognized the way that it's used as a tool, which is every name, whatever we've been named in our life, carries with it our story. So my whole life story was wrapped up with, my human life story is all wrapped up with the name Christina, which was the name my parents gave me. And even that had various nicknames throughout my life. So taking a spiritual name for me was an opportunity so that I could have a space, much like one has a meditation room, where they get to leave their regular life behind. And it's incredible what that can do. And so here I am with my new name. I loved it, Anandi, Blissfield. And I went through a period of time where I had a preference what people called me. I wanted to be called by my spiritual name. When certain people used it, I had a different response or internal reaction than when others used it. Sometimes I was embarrassed to use it. Sometimes I could. It's fascinating, fascinating experiment. And then more recently, what changed yet again was that I noticed one day that I didn't have a preference any longer. I didn't have an internal response one way or the other. And it was absolutely fine with me to be called either or both. It made no difference. And I think this is partially symbolic to what this human experiment is all about, is finding an experiential ground where our human doings and our beings of life and our spiritual reality are interacting with one another harmoniously, in a way that feels good to us. So, having said that, my spiritual name is Anandi, and I was named Christina at my birth. And the translation of my entire name is Blissfield Christ Light. Last name translates to the light. So I personally find that kind of humorous, because this spirituality was the last place that I ever expected or would have considered for myself as the central part of which informs the rest of my life. And yet, here it is from birth that I was given a name that has this translation. Now, you know, is that, was that preordained? I have no idea. It makes no difference to me. But that's the beauty of, excuse me, that's the beauty of this dance with the mind and with the human experience. So that's my story about spiritual names and what is the deal. I hope that you enjoyed it and that it gave you something to consider. You know, consider what's the story, what's the identity around your name for yourself and with others. So that's all for today. If you would like to stay involved with this experiment, which I would love, you can subscribe and follow me on YouTube. And also check out my work and the programs that I'm doing are on www.spiritualvoyagers.com. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.